What's up, everybody? So we're back. Another beautiful morning out, but first things first. We've got our exhaust, which is zip tied on, and looking down in here, you can see the exhaust connects to this header pipe here, but then it kind of runs all the way into this frame before it starts bending, and it pulls the whole thing out. It's real goofy. So we're gonna go run out to the store and see if we can't find any sort of exhaust pipe that's gonna fit this. So we can cut this down, shorten it up, and hopefully get that nice and fixed up. Thought it was gonna be a long shot, but apparently they have something I think will work. Wanted to get the four-wheeler up here because I'm gonna be needing the welder. And here's what I ended up buying. It's just an adapter, but it fits on here. I'm probably gonna cut this here and just use this as a little sleeve, and then that way when I cut this pipe, I'll be able to kind of splice the two pieces together, put my little adapter on, and then I'll weld on both sides, and that should hold it in. So that's the thinking right now. Here's what we're working with, and you can see that by cutting this piece, we can now really adjust the angle that exhaust needs to go. We got our little sleeve, which we'll be able to slide over these two pieces. So even with cutting that, you can see how close we are to the frame. So I'm going to cut that back a hair more, give us some more clearance in here. Here's the issue I'm running into. I put my sleeve in, I put the exhaust on. I can get it pretty nice, kind of where I want it, so that's good. But this little hanger they give you kind of clips dead center of the muffler. So when you go to put it on, if I were to try to bolt this down, it's hitting the frame back in here. So I'm gonna have to find a way to space this off a pretty significant amount, probably about like an inch and a half to hold it there. And I still think this is pretty close to the frame, so I'm probably gonna cut this down even more. I've already taken a good bit off, but I'm gonna take this down even more, get this back so it comes out a little earlier. Then that'll just push this whole muffler back. And I mean, here's the hardware they give you in this kit. So they give you this little bracket, no idea what that's for. The springs obviously to hold the muffler to the exhaust, but then different size bolts, washers. This clamp's gonna be to clamp in here, but other than that, no instructions, no anything. So, and there might be a video on this, but even if I saw the video, and I probably wouldn't like the way they're installing it anyway, so I'm gonna figure out something on my own. I think we got it all mocked up, and before you comment and say, dude, that looks terrible, well, this is just strictly for proof of concept. So I got all these washers. Eventually I'm gonna have to make a spacer, and you can see the exhaust is somewhat close in here, but I think once we get all this tightened up, that's not gonna hit. It's just gonna stay close. So we'll have to make a spacer here, and then you can see we have these little two welded hooks where the spring's gonna go. They line up, and then our coupler here, that'll all get welded together. It just flows into the engine. So I think that's pretty good. I kind of like it here. I did have to take another inch or so off of the exhaust here, so I've cut off a decent amount, but we got plenty of clearance here around the frame, so I won't have any issues there. And just to show how it's going to work with the fender on, kind of a shame we're covering it up, but this is what it looks like underneath. It's tucked away. You're gonna have a little exhaust hitting that flap, but no issues there. All the other clearances are good. So originally what I was going to do was I was just going to butt these two pieces of exhaust together, throw the coupler over it, and then weld this side and weld this side. But looking at it, this actual exhaust pipe is significantly thicker than this little coupler is. So what I'm going to do is chamfer both sides of the exhaust. I'll weld them together, sand it down, and then I'll probably throw the coupler over just weld it on just for good measures. It's kind of excessive, but I think that's the way I'm gonna do it. Here's what I'm working with. I'll pull this collar back. This collar is gonna have to be on this pipe when I weld everything, but I'm not gonna be able to slide it on once this is tacked in. So if I twist this pipe a hair, I can twist this one up a hair. That closes up the gaps pretty good. So I'm gonna tack this in place just like so. We'll be able to pull it off, weld it up fully. Should be good. I'm not gonna fully weld this the whole way around. So like I said, I'm gonna weld this sleeve over top of that seam that we just welded, just as a second layer of protection. And what I'm gonna do is tack it. I'm gonna take the air hose, blow it off, make sure it cools off, and keep on tacking it. Just this metal's so thin, it's gonna probably burn a hole in it. So I gotta be careful, just make sure it stays cool. So here's the final product all cleaned up. Looks pretty good, but you can see like right in this area here where I started running into porosity, so I had to tuck in the garage to try to get out of the wind as much as possible. So I'm liking what I got. The original muffler, it started here, bolted in here, it came back the whole way, kind of curved around here, and it bolted in here. So I do want to build a support that comes off of this bracket, and I think I'm going to weld it onto this piece, which is actually the thinnest piece, so it's the weakest piece, but I think it'll look the best because it looks like the thickest piece. So I'm probably going to build a bracket that'll just weld on here and it'll bolt in here. And that'll just help support the middle of this exhaust, because right now it's just being held in by this bolt here and then the actual head. So it'll just give it a little more rigidity. So I dug around the scrap bin and found this piece of 1/8 inch sheet metal. I'm going to go ahead and cut a little strip out, start making that bracket. This is what our bracket looks like. We're gonna go ahead and tack it in place. We'll have to remove everything and we'll get it fully welded. Woo-wee, check this out, guys. Moto-4 is looking fresh. Even our gap here is pretty darn good. I don't think I could have got that any better. The only thing that could use some major improvements is this stack of washers. So that's what we're gonna work on now. Haven't quite figured out what I'm gonna do about this yet. Man, Home Depot coming in clutch today. They got this 1/2 inch, 16 inch thick steel tube. Look at that. I was really debating to have the same exact thing in aluminum. I was debating on whether or not I wanted to do it in steel or aluminum, but what I'm going to do is create a spacer, and I think I'm actually going to tack it to here. That's why I got the steel, because with this thing being cantilevered, however far that is, like 1.5 to 2 inches, I think that's going to put a lot of stress on just that nut, and I think if I tack that tube on, it'll help, and it should just last a little longer. At least that's how it works in my head. The game we're playing today is exhaust on, exhaust off. It's just anything with fabrication, on and off, on and off. But here is the little spacer I got, the frame cleaned up. I got the spacer cleaned up. Like I said, I'm just gonna tack it onto this frame. And in my opinion, that'll just help hold this. So when that exhaust is bouncing all around, I think it'll just hold better. It'll last longer. Let's get her welded. I like welding, so I just welded the whole thing, welded it the whole way around. What's up, guys? It's the next day. So first thing we're gonna be doing this morning is tearing this exhaust back off. We're gonna clean everything up. We're gonna take this heat shroud off, clean it up, and we're gonna get it all painted. Got everything all sanded down, cleaned up, prepped for paint. We're gonna paint it probably about 3 coats, and then we'll get it back on the bike. While our parts are over there drying, I'm gonna come back over here and I'm gonna go ahead and touch up this little spacer we welded on. I'm gonna clean this up a little, then there's also this rust spot right in here, so I'm gonna get that taken care of and just clean it up a little before we put that exhaust back on. Everything's all painted up, looking brand spanking new. So we did run out of the Rust-Oleum high heat, so we switched over to this stuff. And once we get it back on the bike, we have to just let it idle and let this exhaust heat up to around 400 degrees. Then we'll let it cool off. Then we'll do that a couple times and just let this paint really cure. That's gonna be a wrap on this video. We got the exhaust in. That was a big project to tackle, so I'm glad we got that taken care of. Really? There's not a whole lot left on this thing, so thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned. I'll see you next time.